Alexis!
Stop it, Edward. This may be just another delusion. It must be. Surely I would never lead myself into such a... Oh, my God! Everything could change! Ah, you have all remained safe for so long, my little popsicles. Perhaps you could be of use. Nine, I much prefer you all this way. Ah, there is no avoiding it. We shall have to find our way back inside. Our lives, everything, depends on it. Oh dear! I hope that wasn't a vital organ. Already it's crooked. That's a dead ripping down. I can't even look at it anymore.
Yeah, because the box cannot be in the actual industry building. It needs to be over by power. Otherwise, it's going to cost me, I'm going to have to pay to unlock it later. Hey there, Bandit. I'm doing all right, man. How about you? For Outbreak, I'm assuming that you're following like most of the online guides and running like the M16 and Frenzy Guard or the Gallo. I say that the way I did, but I don't like, I'm not thinking it's bad of you. I'm thinking it's bad of those guides. Like those guides are really bad and they don't like, they're not updated. But naturally, I'm going to assume that's what you're running. Do you have the AMP-63s? Do you have them with the dual-wield attachment yet?
You've got hiding in your closet.
All right, so yeah, run the AMPs dual wield. They are literally the fastest thing to break, like to use on the orbs, and the like they work if not the best, damn near the best on the boss himself to break his armor. But the best part is they allow you to sprint during the boss fight while running. So like unlike every other weapon, you can sit there and shoot the boss without having to worry about getting smacked in the back, because like the M16, you have to stand there to actually shoot it. Meanwhile, the pistols, you know, you can sprint around shooting the boss the whole time. But use the AMPs to break his armor. And then you can use the AMPs to destroy the orbs as well. Like, they're hella fast. Or just pull out and, like, pop your Aether Shroud. Sorry, run Aether Shroud. I should have said that first. Run Aether Shroud. Run around sprinting to shoot the armor, or to shoot the break the armor. And then when the orbs come out, just pop your Aether Shroud and shoot the orbs while, you know, you don't have to worry about zombies then. Or if you want to use a flamethrower for the orbs, that works hella fast as well. One second, I'll be able to focus on chat. I can't really during this step, because if I look away from these zombies, they'll despawn. And I can't tell you the amount of times I've actually like died doing this, even with megas. This is literally the one situation in all of zombies where I ever suggest or have to walk backwards. Normally I would always tell you, like I always tell you guys, don't ever walk backwards, you know. Zombies are gonna be behind you 100%. But you back yourself into a corner and then it's rip. This situation, you have to. And no problem there, Brush. Happy to help, man. Yeah, the ones from the catwalk, they can despawn literally if you, I mean, the way I was looking at them, if I would have like not looked at them for too long, they'll despawn, and it's crazy. Like, this was nothing. The real, like, even, like doing it with megas, the trick is managing to get at least, like you have to get, shit, what was it? 9 zombies. I want to say it's 9. You have to get 9 zombies from the catwalk. In this, I only had 5. So imagine doing this with 9 zombies all fucking sprinting like that and having to maneuver around like that. It's actually, like I said, I can't tell you the amount of times I actually went down doing it. Hey there, Naya. How are you doing tonight?
Hi, Wolfie! Greedy little ingrate. Not so much as a thank you bark.
What are your PC specs? I'm just curious. That has nothing to do with like leaving it on over there. Although I could, like if you do get to the point where you have like an overheating problem, let me know and I'll teach you how to, undervolt. Or at least suggest looking up undervolt, I guess. The way you can actually get a detailed guide of it. But you shouldn't have any kind of issue like that, because I doubt you have like the specs that would do something like that.
This will make a suitable shield component.
Like if you got a pre-built, it shouldn't be any kind of issue. Alright, so yeah, you shouldn't have any kind of issue like that. Although, you lost me when you said GTS. I'm assuming it's something involving sleep. Oh. My guess was get that sleep. Close enough.
I saw this in the Chronorium. The part that I skimmed.
And we got a double points. Bet. I like how it's invisible. I like how the shield thing, the blue glow, is invisible for some reason.
Ah, spectral essence. Now, if I only had some receptacle to store it in. Ugh, perhaps Nikolai has an extra pocket. The shield appears calibrated to both absorb.
That's basically what your That's basically what your game is stored on. Like the NVMe M2, those are the fastest type of SSDs. After that, it just comes down to like what specific SSD you got. But by default, that like those are really good. Like that's what you would have wanted. I don't know where the fuck I was going. Although I do need to go ahead and check the numbers actually.
Could this be his inner sanctum? The writing all over the wall certainly doesn't scream sanity. It reminds me of my lab.
Sure. Hold your breath and I'll be there before you know it. I mean, I won't be, but you'll be passed out from holding your breath so long and it, you know, won't matter then.
The doctor calling. Calling this place an infirmary is offensive.
Starting to feel like we might not be able to get the spark this round. Got three more places we can check. Now let's see how troll anywhere but here is going to be this game.
I don't understand.
Hey, that actually wasn't a bad one.
It's like licorice dipped in pretentiousness.
I've checked everywhere that you can check, or that I can check on this round. The only two places that I, or three places that I haven't checked that I'm unable to check is down in showers, by the last perk down at docks, and then behind the fence down there at the very bottom of docks. Yeah, it's going to be one of those three places and I can't get to those. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Wait, did I say gem again? I meant showers. Yeah, that's the place I can't check. That's one of the three. One second, let's actually let anywhere but here come off cooldown. I'm gonna use it on this dog round to I'm gonna attempt to find the spark. Ouch. I was about to say, bring lube and everything, huh? Because after the praying, I'm going to realize how screwed I got by the anywhere but here. Dog should give me back my specialist. Should. right, it's close enough. Let's go ahead and get the zombie killed over here. How did your stream go earlier? Zombie's like, first you're trying to run away from me, now you're trying to get me close. Make up your damn mind. Good, good. I'm glad to hear that. One of these days, I'll actually make it a goal to go for like a round. Like best case scenario, like I've done it by round 12 with classics. Pretty sure I can knock off like three or four rounds of that if I actually reset to get monkeys out of the box. I mean, imagine a fucking round 8, round 9 with classics. Hey there, Precise. What's going on, man?
Enhancing drinks always smell like poison.
No, though, just running this classic blood back for the fucking 24th time.
Must have been the runway site for Sal and the others. Judging from the big sign, it seems that they finally got the idea. Yeah, guten Tag, Kurs. I was wondering if by chance you've seen. Sit it down just there.
Of course, there would be freaking 13 zombies that sprint. Not to mention how he makes them fucking super sprint in front of him. No, you can't use a specialist exploit on with classics like that. Not this early. Like, I literally open the doors with just points regularly. Like, on round one, you can get the points. You shoot every zombie in the leg once, and then kill, knife them. Leave one zombie. You're able to get down to the first power so that you can open the door to catwalk. Still round one. And then with the catwalk zombies, you just shoot each one in the leg, then knife. That allows you to have over 4k points, to which you can get down to power. And plus killing that gives you two wardens to kill right there. One from catwalk, and then another from actually flipping the power switch on. And hell, they give you like 1500 points by themselves. Yeah, I had all these doors open on round one, not round three. Come on, that's fucked up. Just use a permanent unlock token on it. Naya, are you still here?
Nine? Breathe deep, Richthofen. The sooner you go nose blind, the better.
Nice. Shit. I adjust my mic and now I keep like bumping into it because it. Okay, maybe that'll be better. So I better not pick up the spark, actually. Yeah, let's hold off on picking it up. Since my shield's so low, just to be safe. I mean, if you were really into it and wanted to get into it, I mean, it's not hard. Now, this crazy shit like this that I'm doing, that's a different story. No, I mean, it can get difficult for certain things, but it's more tedious than anything. Like, those specific few, like blood. As far as I'm aware, the gum should have still been okay, to be honest. I don't think there's much trick to that. I mean, chose to eat it. I think I fucked up by using my specialist right then. Maybe you dig up something useful. and specialist just had to drop right then.
Ready for special.
See you here in a moment. I know for sure.
To unlock the double points
so that I can use it for later. Using the shield blast on that opens that door.
Oh no, it stays open. I mean, at least I've never had it close on me, and that's like, you see how long I'm taking to do like each round because of doing all this crazy stupid optimizations.
I mean, it could have been a feature like early on as well.
it's a spook. But be honest, who are you more frightened of? The same man with a knife?
Or the lunatic with the spoon?
Sanity is overrated!
Alright, that's all I can really do this round.
Thank you.
course, there just has to be those freaking sprinting zombies that are in front of him. Urgh.
slices or thick.
Where's this sword? Just walk up.
Fuck yes, we get to start bird on round five. Instead of round six. All right, let's see if we can get the damn shield upgrade within 8k points. I think someone forgot to tell this asshole it's round four. Where the hell is this other zombie?
Thank you.
Fuck. Rope. Definitely not going to be able to buy Winter's Well. Basically, we got 3 more box hits, and we need that damn shield upgrade to be within then. Fuck. They ruined my whole fucking game right here. There's one way this could possibly still work, but even then, I'm still not as good as it should be, just because I'm starting fucking bird round. Like, I'll be starting, no, that's bird round. I'm thinking of challenges. Okay, there's one way this can still work then. And that's managing to fucking get the upgraded next round after respawning zombies while not killing any. That in itself is going to be a hell of a challenge.
time you start kicking or screaming.
I don't know why this has my heart rate up hella high. Fucking intense. Give me just a moment. Let me grab a fresh drink real quick, guys. One second, I'm trying to cool my GPU for some reason. Like, I'm having to adjust the fans because it's at fucking 67. It shouldn't be going over 65. There we go.
not so much the aftertaste. Still steaming from the last trip. My God! So dizzy! So thirsty!
So my, like, my button to pull out my shield is by clicking my mouse button down. I keep accidentally, like, pressing too hard, and it's pulling out my shield as I'm switching weapons as well. Because, you know, mouse scroll wheel is how I'm switching weapons. That's the reason you keep seeing me randomly pulling out my shield while respawning the zombies. shit. Come on, come on.
To feel quite crispy. Souls collected. Obnoxious surprise. At least as he was. After the three were executed, he disappeared without a trace.
12,042 bottles of beer on the wall. 12,042 bottles of beer. One down, you pass it around. 12,041 bottles of beer on the wall.
Samuel? levitating.
Stop the bird! Stop the bird! Stop!
He's taken a personal interest.
The book is gone!
Giving me a nervous breakdown.
Why can nothing ever be simple?
And what exactly would you know about his Samuel, hmm?
Jeez, touchy-touchy. Ever since you guys switched off, I've been hearing all kinds of freaky, geeky chatter in this place. Haven't been able to make out much with that little bird. He chirps pretty loud.
Brilliant, Samuel. I was unaware you were fluent in seagulls. It's like jumping into a hair dryer. Good. We've arrived. Is my face red? I feel red.
I was not trying to buy the fucking trap. Drop points. have any ammo to kill the warden next round, actually. I got a really dumb idea. Anyone happen to recall if Pack was over at spawn? Let's see. Check the stream from the YouTube so I can make sure. Because this round's going to flip any second. It was not. All right, so I need to go down to docks for the Pack. Before this round flips. Hey there, Revenger, what's going on?
I have underestimated the Wardens this much. How could he have the knowledge to build this? Ready for spectral discharge.
Now it's flipped around. Call 911. If it's something serious, you should definitely call 911, oh man. I'm serious. If it's that bad. Don't they have an emergency service in the UK like that? Like anything like that? Sorry, a 999 for you. I apologize. I think that's what it is. Yeah, it's 999. Just 999. Alright. Hopefully it's nothing serious, but if you can, come back, let us know, you know, if everything's okay, once everything's okay. All right, one more time and we'll stop farming points.
Maybe you'll choke on the splinters.
only answer.
Holy shit, we finally have the chance to do this, guys. Round 12. The thing it comes down to now is challenges. This has been a good-ass game, honestly. Like, a good-ass game so far. Fingers crossed challenges don't completely screw me. Behind that fucking trap somehow.
What's next?
Fucking temporal or the temporal thing. Shit. Anyways, the gobble gum that increases, or the elixir that increases the time of power ups, wasn't off cooldown. I should have paid attention to that.
Gentlemen, I believe his brain is beginning to thaw. You fools! Can you not see it? There is a pattern. At long last, there is a pattern to this madness. That I suspected all along, of course. I know what I'm doing. Starting to feel quite crispy. Thank you.
bring up the whole picture so I can keep track of the keep track easier. Now this is going to be a fun challenge. Try not to kill zombies during this one. Second, just taking a sip of my drink and everything. A little 30 second break because this has actually had me freaking like heart rate high as hell being so close to freaking pulling this off again. Alrighty, here goes nothing.
Thank you.
something from the last trip.
What the doctor ordered!
Yoo-hoo! Yeah, you're at the control panel. I would give anything to replace one of the imbeciles on my...
Ain't gonna lie, that was pretty damn clean.
Nein, you can't, Samuel. You are frozen in ein pod in mein lab. Just accept it.
you make this?
Because it tastes like you made this.
Shit, what was the damn number? Fuck. One second, let's check. Should have marked it down.
I'm still steaming from the last trip.
Please be Simon Says, or not Simon Says, please be Morse code. Fuck.
Interested in improving himself with scholarly pursuits. To help with your studies.
Take cover! This is going to make a mess. Yeah, I can feel good about that. Death by mincing, justice done. When can we leave? Refer to me as Ed again, Sammy, and I will press the pulse button on your cryopod repeatedly. Now, unless you have anything useful to say, kindly silence your brain. What's next?
Well, fuck. That's a rip.
Thank you. Roderick's suggestion, Samuel. That one is the least offensive.
So the first one is 1.4 dash.
So that's 1.4 dash, 2.3 dash.
Yeah.
Holy fuck. Okay, I'm actually... Then look, about to pull this off on round 11.
Mine edges are starting to feel quite crispy.
Immortal soul be somehow able to activate the warden's mechanism? Because if it is, I will happily toss your pod into the bay.
Thank you. Warden's body as a conduit to his soul, the same as it has done before. As for the others inside, well, everything will be wunderbar.
I got something! Guess what, Riton? I can speak Seagull! And he says...
Not now, Samuel!
In my brain.
Jumping fucking Jeremiah, you're alive! Oh, woo. Man, do you have any idea how scary it is? Huh? Thinking you're gonna be stuck in a box with your own thoughts forever?
Yes, Samuel. I'm afraid I do.
Your magnum opus. I applaud your dedication, Herr Warden, but your Armageddon is locked in here with you.
Discharge!
Finn. Al. That teensy little seagull. The ghost of Alcatraz have bought us the time. Knows every moment. The thawing sequence has begun. We must finish what we have started and confront our fate above.
Dude, I've been trying to get another round 12 run in. No joke, like 24 freaking runs. And then this shit happens. Like, I'm over here with a heart rate of like 170. Fucking. I expect this round to end before the fight's over with, but. Because round 11 alone, fucking like a whole other level. I'm trying to fucking hurry up and get this done before the round flips, because if I pull it off round 10, like, I don't know what the fuck to do. Like, wait, what? Yeah, you gotta get down to one zombie, and then you can go open power and open the catwalk. Kill the first nine, like kill all the ones that run down the regular catwalk. Shoot the warden, to get him to come out. And then when you start going down the actual like the front yard part. You have to kill the first zombie just coming towards you.
The lab.
And then there's like three dogs. Kill them. The next set, there'll be three zombies. You leave. Like, you keep them, but kill the two dogs that come after it. And then there's two more zombies and like another dog. You keep the dog, or you keep the zombies, but kill the dogs. Holy shit. Oh, that's, yeah. That's not the hard part. The hard part is managing to get the... Because this isn't done with monkeys out of the box. This is done by getting the free monkeys.
That's
if I started running it back to get the monkeys out of the box...
I would be greatly relieved if that were so.
If I had a game as good as this one, I could pull it off by round 8 with classics.
That will not be necessary, Nikolai. The future has changed. Read it. Learn of your true calling. You must keep your soul. It will be needed to defeat Dr. Monty.
Who?
Hello? Hello? I am still here.
Nah. Fuck that, because that will literally require not only me to, like, I started Bird on round 5 on this run.
What have I done?
And that's with getting the free, with the free monkeys. 2 rounds were from just to get the, like, my specialist charged up to get the free monkeys.
As such,
and freaking, like, no, just that alone, like getting it by round 5 was,
I wish I could,
fucking, like, ridiculous.
Sorry, Edward.
So, but take that out. But round 8 would require me to have a game as good as this one.
No, you can help me.
As well as managing to get the monkeys out of the box first hit.
Don't you know?
Or like within, sorry, not first hit. I would actually have like 8 hits
I
to get it.
Witness.
Somewhere between 6 to 8.
Calamities. Dimensions born.
And if I didn't get monkeys, it'd be a complete rip, so I'd have to run it all the way back.
No! I want to be me. Someone who did all the hard work! I wanted...
My PC sounds like it's about to fucking take off, though. I don't know what it is about BO4 that it fucking, it overheats the hell out of my PC.
You won't